Sabbath. I'm so glad to be joining you through the airwaves on this most celebratory Sunday. It's Palm Sunday. So before we get into Holy Week, where we know Jesus suffers and dies before his resurrection, we are going to welcome him, just like the crowds did 2,000 years ago as he entered into the city of Jerusalem. This morning, I think you will be pleased to see a familiar face as Joanne Walcott plays for us. It's just good to see each other, isn't it? But before we do anything this morning, I would like for you to go and get a cracker, a piece of bread, an animal cookie, whatever it is, and I mean people of all ages. Kids, you go too. Get some grape juice, orange juice, milk, water, whatever it is. And I want you to bring those things back because we are going to commune. All right? I pray that you have gotten your latest newsletter with the enclosed letter to all of you. Just one thing I want to mention is we will be doing our services by telecom until the end of April at least. So just wanted to let you know. Our call to worship is meant to be done in unison. But since we can't do that, I would ask you to gather your thoughts, to close your eyes, and to fix your minds on Jesus. Our Heavenly Father, we, your humble children, invoke your blessing upon us. We adore you, whose name is love, whose nature is compassion, whose presence is joy, whose word is truth, whose spirit is goodness, whose holiness is beauty, whose will is peace, whose service is perfect freedom, and in knowledge of whom stands our eternal life. Unto you be all honor and glory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Would you join me in prayer, please? Oh Lord, we come to you as your children. And God, what a blessing it is to know that you love us. We pray that you would be delighted in what we do this morning. And Lord, may your compassion come down on us like sweet rain. May you be the author and the perfecter of our faith in everything we do this morning and in our days ahead. In Jesus' name we pray it. Amen.
Hosanna, loud Hosanna, the little children sang through pillared court and temple. The lovely anthem rang.
Kids, come on down. I miss you so much, especially this Sunday, because you know I like to go around the church with our palm leaves. But I want you to come down, because we're going to do communion together, all right? I just wanted to talk to you a little bit about what's happening. Besides the virus, what's happening in our spiritual world? What's happening as we remember the Sunday that Jesus went into Jerusalem and people were saying, "Oh, Hosanna, Hosanna." And they were calling him a king and they loved him. But yet by the end of the week, they would turn against him. And the same people who were saying, "Hosanna," would be yelling, "Crucify him, crucify him." Wow. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. I want to do communion with my friends. And I can see each one of you. I can see you here. And I can see us sharing a bowl of grapes and our animal crackers. So if you, whatever you have, it's fine. The important thing is that we're together, at least through the air, and that we love each other. All right? So, I just want you to remember, it was the night before Jesus was going to die. And, you know, I think if that was me, I would be all about, well, okay, I've got a little bit of time left. What do I want to do? Do I want to play video games? Do I want to read? Do I want to make something to eat? Well, Jesus said, "I want to be with my friends. I want to taste some bread. I want to drink some juice. I want to celebrate that important holiday that they call Passover." So I want you to imagine each of the kids that come up here for Kids Club. Sometimes we have guests from other towns. Sometimes we have quite a few kids, sometimes not so much. But I want you to imagine all of your church friends sitting up here and getting ready for the Lord's Supper. On that night when Jesus gathered with his friends, they had bread. This is my bread today. And Jesus told his friends, he said, "I want you to eat this and remember me. Remember." And so they took the bread after Jesus had blessed it. He lifted it to heaven, blessed it, and they ate. So can we all eat it this time? And then after the supper, he took wine or juice and he told his disciples, "Drink this and remember me." And so, let's all take our glass, our cup, whatever you have. And as you drink, I want you to remember Jesus and I want you to remember each person in our group, in our kids' club, in our children's bells. Remember. take our drink, and we do remember you, Jesus. Lord Jesus, I pray that you would be with each one of these boys and girls this week, that you would create in them a kind heart, a gentle spirit. Lord, I pray that you would allow them to be nice to their parents and to their brothers and sisters, to their friends. Help them with their online homework. And until we meet again, we will give you all the honor. Amen. Okay, kids, have a great week. And I'll see you again next week, Easter Sunday. Our scripture this morning comes from the book of Matthew. I'm in the 26th chapter. If you'd like to get your Bibles and read along, that would be wonderful. If not, just listen to me read. I'm on verse 17. On the first day of the festival of unleavened bread, the disciples came to Jesus and asked, "Where do you want us to prepare the Passover meal?" "As you go into the city," he told them, "you will see a certain man. Tell him, the teacher says, my time has come, and I will eat the Passover meal with my disciples at your house." So the disciples did as Jesus told them and prepared the Passover supper there. When it was evening, Jesus sat down at the table with the 12 disciples. While they were eating, he said, "The truth is, one of you will betray me." Greatly distressed, one by one, they began to ask him, "I'm not the one, am I, Lord?" He replied, "One of you who is eating with me now will betray me. For I, the Son of Man, must die, as the scriptures declared long ago. But how terrible it will be for my betrayer. Far better for him if he had never been born." Judas, the one who would betray him, also asked, "Teacher, I'm not the one, am I?" And Jesus told him, "You have said it yourself." As they were eating, Jesus took a loaf of bread and asked God's blessing on it. Then he broke it in pieces and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take and eat, for this is my body." And he took a cup of wine and gave thanks to God for it. He gave it to them and said, "Each of you drink from it. For this is my blood, which seals the covenant between God and his people. It is poured out to forgive the sins of many. Mark my words, I will not drink wine again until the day I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom." Then they sang a hymn and went out to the Mount of Olives. I think this past month, almost 2 months, have made me realize how important it is to share a meal with loved ones. It's something we take for granted, isn't it? Even I miss going to the local restaurants and looking across the aisle and recognizing friends and neighbors. There's something about sharing a meal. You may have had to cancel meals with your kids or your grandparents or siblings. And all of a sudden, that act has become precious. You know, when Jesus gathered with his disciples on the night before he was crucified, he met with a group of people that he didn't know 3 years before. You know, we tend to eat with people kind of like us. Not only family and friends, but almost we choose a group of people maybe in the same economic strata. Well, that's not what Jesus did. If you could have been there, a fly on the wall, and seen this group of people who Jesus was eating with, they were, well, maybe not misfits, but they surely weren't the group of people that society would have deemed worthy. We have probably some stinking fishermen. We had a tax collector. I think we had women there. I think there were probably children. And this is who Jesus chose to eat his last meal on earth with. And when you think about the Last Supper, I do not want you to imagine Da Vinci's picture with everybody set up, you know, all looking out at the camera. That's not how it was. They probably, most probably, ate in the Roman way, where they were seated more lounge-like, at a low table. And they were most certainly in a circle. And that's how I like to think of it, that Jesus is looking around that table, that he can see everybody eye to eye. And they celebrate that ancient Passover meal, the one the Jews had been celebrating for more than a millennium. They were celebrating the time when Moses took the Israelites out of Egypt. And do you remember the old story where the Jews were to put the blood of a lamb over their doorposts, and the angel of death would pass over these houses and notice the blood, and they would not harm anyone in the house. So Jesus is gathering with people celebrating God's mercy, God's covenant. And when Jesus had supper with them that night, he changed everything. He finished out the cycle of covenants that God had been making to God's people for centuries. Jesus said, "This is my body. Every time you do it, every time you eat this bread, remember me." And then when he passed around the glass of wine, he said, "This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for the many for the remission of sins." And they did. And we do. So I want you to get your bread, get your cracker, whatever you're eating this morning, God doesn't care, and get your drink, whether it be coffee or juice, water, a thimble full of wine, and I want us to commune together. in turbulent times, and we are, but God, that night when Jesus met with his disciples and his friends, it was mayhem. And Jesus knew that he was going to die. So God, we're in good company. You never promised an easy road, but you did promise that you'd be with us on our path. Thank you, God. And so Jesus took the bread and he lifted it to heaven for God to bless, and he passed it out among the people gathered there, and he said, "Take and eat. This is my body broken for you." And so, God, we do. Thank you. And after the meal, Jesus took the final cup of wine and he lifted it up to the Father to bless. And then he passed it around to the people gathered there. And he said, "Take, drink. This is my blood of the new covenant. And every time you do it, friends, remember me." And so, Lord, we do. And although I know we have prayer in common because of what is going on in the world, still we have our individual prayers. We have our individual joys and sorrows and questions and needs. So I am going to start this prayer, and I will pause, and you say your own prayer, and then I will say, Lord, in your mercy, and you answer, hear our prayer. All right? Okay, let's pray. Dear Lord, this morning we come as people of joy and sorrow, all at the same time. We come as fulfilled yet hungry. We come as sated and thirsty. We're human, God, and Jesus, you know what it was like to be human. So you understand the complexity of our emotions and our thoughts. So God, we just pray that you would be in the middle of our prayers here. As together we pray for the people of this congregation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the people who suffer and those in trouble. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For the concerns of this local community, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For the world, its people, and its leaders, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. For the Church Universal, its leaders, its members, and its mission, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And in communion with the saints, we repeat and send forth the prayer that Jesus the Christ taught us while here on earth. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. It's time for our offering. And although we can't take it in person, please continue to send your offering, your tithes, your gifts, so that our congregation can stay afloat through this turbulent time. In your newsletter this week, you will receive an envelope that says Easter offering. Place your offerings into that, please, and either mail them back to us or drop them by while I or Bernice is in the office. That would be fine. And thank you. We use this money to further the kingdom of God, absolutely, and to keep our lights on. Dear Lord, we ask that you bless this money a very tangible way that we can say, I love you, I honor you, I serve you with all that I am. And God, we pray that you would use your divine touch to multiply it, and that you would use it where you need and want to. We love you, God. Amen. Are you ready to sing Alleluia? Can you picture the people that are usually on your right and to your left? Can you picture the camaraderie we feel as we sing? Ready? Alleluia. 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 Now go. Be the people God has designed you to be. Be a light in the darkness. Be the Easter people that I know you are. Amen.